Hi guys, welcome to this video. I just feel like dropping something on my YouTube channel and I feel like testing my HTML knowledge. Okay, so let's quickly look for an HTML quiz. Let's go to Google and type HTML quiz. Okay, so let's go for W3 Schools HTML quiz. Okay, so we have 40 questions in each, and then at the end of the quiz we are going to see the score we get, and we have to start the quiz. Good luck. Let's do it together. Stay on the video. So I'm gonna start the video now. Okay, so question number one says, what does HTML stands for? We have home tools markup language, hypertext markup language, hyperlinks, and text markup language. I think B should be the correct answer, because HTML is an hypertext markup language for designing on web pages and so on. So B should be the correct answer, hypertext markup language. So who is making the web standards? That's question number two. Who is making the web standards? Option A says the World Wide Web. B says Mozilla. C says Google. And D says Microsoft. We are talking of the web standards. We are talking of the WWW World Wide Web. Yes, I think A should be the answer. Okay, so question three says, choose the correct HTML element for the largest heading. When we are talking of heading, we are talking of H1 to H6. H1, I think, is descending under. H2 will be small. H3 will be smaller. We are talking of the largest heading. That should be H1. Yes, H1 should be the largest heading. So let's choose H1. We have question number four. What is the correct HTML element for inserting a line break? Okay, when we are talking of a line break, we are talking of we need a break, just like the white stuff we are seeing here, just a break in our HTML document. And we have option A, LB, option B, BR, option C, break. When we are talking of break, we are talking of BR. The BR tag is a single tag. It doesn't have the closing tag. It's just BR. So option B should be the answer. Okay, so we have question five. What is the correct HTML for adding a background color? So to add a background color in HTML, that means we are talking of we have the option A here, body BG equals yellow. I think that's not the correct answer. We have the option B, background yellow. Nope, that's not the correct answer. And we have the option C, body star equals background color yellow. I think C should be the correct standard for adding a background color to our HTML document. Okay, so we have a question six here. Don't forget, we are going to 40, and stay on the page, stay on the video. We are going to see what we score at the end of the video. Okay, so we have the question six here. Six of 40. Choose the correct HTML element to define important text. When we are talking of important thing, that means text that are audible, that is highlighted, that we want to call people attention to, that this text is important. So we have the option A, we have the B tag, we have important, and we have I. Then we have option D, we have strong. This question is somehow corny. We have B, important, I. I'm not very sure of this, but I'll go for D, strong. It should make the text stronger. It should make it more audible. Okay, so we have the question 7 here. Choose the correct HTML element to define emphasize text. When we are talking about emphasize, that means the text will be somehow slant. Okay, so we have the option A here. Italics, I. Sorry, we have the option A, I. We have B, italic, and C, E, M. So, as pronounced, emphasize. The answer is C. Okay, question number 8. What is the correct HTML for creating a hyperlink? Okay, so to create a hyperlink, that means the link that is referring to another page, maybe on your website or another website, and so on. That means the address of a page. Okay, so we have the option A here, name equals no. If you want to define an hyperlink, you don't use name. We have option B, URL equals nope. Option C, href equals http://www.schools, and option D. I think C should be the answer. Href, when defining an hyperlink in HTML, use the href attribute. So href equals. Okay, so we have the question 9 here. Which character is used to indicate an end tag? So in HTML, we have the opening and closing tag. The closing tag has a forward slash. So I think B should be the answer. B should be the answer. How can you open a link in a new tab or browser window? Let's read the question. How can you open a link in the new tab or browser window? We have option A, HTML equals URL new. We have option B, A, HTML equals URL target equals underscore blank, and C, A equals URL target equals new. When we are talking of, let me explain the question. When we are talking of open a new tab or browser window, that means if I just create or open a new tab like this. So the question says, how can we do it in HTML? You can do it by saying target equals underscore blank to open a new tab or browser window. So B should be the answer. Let's go for B. Okay, question number 11. So which of these elements are all table elements? Option A says table head, T foot. Option B says table R, TD. Option C says T head, body, TR. Option D says table, TR, and TT. When we are talking of table, that means we are talking of table, the table role, and the table data. So option B should be the answer. Let's go for option B. So question number 12 says, inline elements are normally displayed without starting a line. Is the statement true or false? When we are talking of a line element, that means if I add a text to this question, it won't break. Is the question true or false? Yes, because if I add, maybe I just edit I edit this code and I add a span element to it, it won't break. It will just append the word after it. That's true. It won't start a line. The question is true. Yep, we should go for two. How can you make a number list? When we are talking of listing or in HTML, we are talking of the OL and UL. So OL and UL is similar, with list is not there and del is not there. But to make a number list, we have OL is on ordered list and UL is on ordered list. And to make a number is OL, yes, ordered list. How can you make a bullet list? A bullet list. I said it earlier that UL and OL is making a list. To make a list, the list and DL is not there. So we need to work on UL and LI. So how can you make a bullet list? To make a bullet list, that should be on other list. Another list, yep. Okay, please don't forget to like, subscribe. Okay, question 15 says, what is the correct HTML for making a checkbox? To make a checkbox, that means you want to confirm something, that's the usefulness, that you want to confirm something, that maybe you are a male, you are a female, I agree to terms and conditions, and so on. So we have option A, input type equals checkbox. We have option B, checkbox. Option C, check. Option D, type equals check. In HTML, is if you want to define a checkbox, you use, I think the answer should be A, input type equals checkbox. Okay, so we have question 16. Don't forget, we are going to 40. Let's do it together. What is the correct HTML for making a text input field? To make a text input field, in HTML, we have input type equals password, type equals text, type equals checkbox, like the one we just did earlier. But to make a input field in HTML, we have options here. We have text input type equals text, input type equals text field. We have text field and have input type equals text. Option A should be the answer, input type equals text. Okay, question 17 of 40. What is the correct HTML for making a drop-down list? When we are talking of drop-down, let me give you an example. In this page, if I just click on this, I will see this is a fancy drop-down. So how can we do it in HTML? So we have option A, type equals drop down. We have option B, select. We have option C, list. And we have option D, type equals list. When we want to make a drop down, we use the select tag. Yep. So this select tag will take options and so on. Question 18. What is correct HTML for making a text area? As pronounced text area. Option A, we have the type equals text box. Option B, we have the text area. And option C, we have type equals text area. To make a text area, we use the text area tag. Okay, question number 19 of 40. What is the correct HTML for inserting an image? We have option A, image source equals image.gif. We have img source equals image. We have option C and we have option D. When we are talking of to insert an image, we use, let me give you an example, or let me explain this question. Look at option A and option B. They are very similar, very similar, but the difference is this one is image and this one is img. The standard way to define an image in HTML is B, yes, img, not image, img, source equals image.gif. So this alt is used to define, maybe if the image does not work. Okay, let's click on next. Question 20 of 40. What is the correct HTML for inserting a background image? I think we did this earlier. Okay, so let's do it. Okay, we have option A. Let me read the question. What is the correct HTML for inserting a background image? We have option A, BG equals. We have option B, background, and we have option C. So style equals background image. URL background GIF. So I will go for that. Okay, question number 21. An iframe is used to display a web page within a page. Is the statement true or false? Yes, I can define an iframe here and display another website like Facebook, Instagram, and so on. So it's used to display a web page within a page. The statement is true. Question number 22. HTML comment starts with this and end with this. Yeah, true. You want to define a comment. Question number 23. Block elements are normally displayed without starting a new line. The statement should be first. I said earlier that even to define an inline element, it won't start a new line. But a block element, if I add a div here, it will start a new line. So the statement is false. Okay, question number 24. Which HTML element defines the title of a body? To define a title of a body, use the title. Let's go for, we have title, head, and meta. Let's go for title. Okay, question number 25 says, which HTML attribute specify an alternate text for an image if the image cannot display? I explained this earlier that the alt attribute works when the image does not, maybe did not work. Yes, when the image did not work, the alt attribute will give a message that this image maybe is a cat. Maybe you uploaded an image that is cat. You can just define the alt attribute. So the alt attribute work if the image cannot be displayed. Okay, so the alt attribute should be the answer. We have title, we have long text, we have source, and we have alt. Which doc type is correct for HTML5? We have HTML. Option A says doc type HTML. Option B says option B in capital letter, and option C. So option A should be the standard way of declaring an HTML5 doc type. Okay, question number 27 or 40. Which HTML element is used to specify a footer for a document or session? To define a footer, that means footer, that's the last page under your web page. Yes, maybe the last section, like this one. I will say this is the footer. This is the footer here. So which HTML tag is used to define it? Which HTML element is used to define a footer for a document or session? So I'll go for B. Option A says bottom. Option B says footer. And option C says section. To define a footer in HTML, use the footer tag. Question number 28 says, in HTML, you can embed SVG elements directly into an HTML page. In HTML, you can embed SVG elements directly into an HTML page. Is it true or false? Yes, that should be true. You can easily embed SVG element into your HTML page. Question number 29 says, what is the correct HTML element for plain video files? For playing video files, we have option A, movie, option B, video, option C, media. To play a video, use the video element. Okay, what is the correct HTML element for playing audio file? To play an audio, we have sound, audio, and MP3. Use the audio element. Okay, so we have question number 31. HTML global attributes. Content dtable is used to. We have specify whether the content is an element. Specify whether the content of an element should be editable or not. Update content from the server. Return the position of the first occurrence of content inside a string. And we have the option D, specifies a content menu for an element. The menu appears when a user right click on the element. Yes, I think D is the answer. D, it specifies something. In HTML, unblur and unfocus are. We have the event attribute, we have the styles attribute, and we have the HTML element. Unblur should be event attribute. So, question number 33. Graphics defined by SVG is in HTML. Graphics defined by SVG is in which format? Okay, graphics defined by SVG is in which format? We have XML, we have HTML, and we have CSS. That should be XML, not HTML, CSS. Okay, question number 34. The HTML canvas element is used to draw graphics, display database, manipulate data in MySQL, creating the aggregable element. When we are talking of HTML, that this question or this option are fun. The option is fun. Draw graphics, display database records, manipulate data in MySQL. Option A, let me go for option A. Okay, question number 35. In HTML, which attribute is used to specify that an input field must be filled out? We have form validate, we have validate, we have required, and we have the placeholder. When we want to insist that user must input something on the tag, and if an input tag you defined, use the required to say that this field must be filled out. Yes, use the required. Which input type defines a slider control? We have search, we have slider, we have controls, we have range. So this should be the answer. Which HTML element is used to display a scalar measurement within a range? Which HTML element is used to define a scalar measurement within a range? We have measure, we have gauge, we have range, and we have meter. To define a scalar measurement, I think meter should be the answer. Okay, question number 38. Which HTML element define navigation links? When I'm talking of navigation, that means like the header you are looking in. This is a fixed header, I think so. Yes, a fixed header. Navigation link. Which HTML defines navigation links? We have navigation, we have navigate, and nav. C should be the answer, nav. Yes. Oh, cool. We are in number 39. Wow. After this, we have one question left. In HTML, what does the aside element define? We have option A, a navigation list to show at the left side of the page. We have the ASCII character set to send information between computers on the internet. And we have the C, content aside from the page content. Yes. Let us choose C. The last question. Which HTML element is used to specify a header for a document or session? Which HTML element is used to specify a header? That means we want to specify a header for the document or session. So we have the top, we have the session, we have the header and head. So let's go for the header or head. It's very similar. But when defining an header in an HTML document, we use the header element. Wow, I scored 39 over 40. Wow, 39 over 40. So, okay, I got 97%. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. YouTube, I will drop the link below the video description. You can just take practice on HTML. Please subscribe. Don't forget to share to your friends. See you next. Bye.